If you live somewhere that gets below freezing in the winter, you've probably heard stories of water pipes bursting during cold weather. It happened to my house one time, but you almost never hear about the same thing happening to fire hydrants. Well, that is because we use different types of hydrants in different places depending on how cold it gets, and the ones in cold places don't have any water in them to freeze. Places with mild climates, like the southern US, tend to use what are called wet barrel fire hydrants. Water from underground pipes flows all the way up into the tall, above-ground section of the hydrant, called the barrel, even when the hydrant's not in use. When firefighters need water, they just turn a valve near the top and it comes rushing out. But wet barrel fire hydrants would be terrible in places with colder winters because freezing temperatures outside the barrel would freeze the water inside too. Water gets bigger when it freezes, so expanding ice inside a hydrant would push against the inside walls and squeeze any liquid water left in the hydrant, eventually making the hydrant crack or explode. This is why pipes burst in the winter. They're not strong enough to withstand the pressure exerted by expanding ice. And it's why wet barrel hydrants would explode in the winter too, if we use them everywhere. So to avoid that mess, dry barrel hydrants are used. As you might have guessed from the name, dry barrel hydrants are normally dry, meaning they don't have any water in the barrel when they're not in use. Instead, the water stays underground in water mains, which are buried below the frost line, the depth where temperatures don't drop below freezing even in the dead of winter. In most places, that's just a couple meters below your feet. In the UK and a few other countries, they take this to the next level and they don't have any part of the hydrant above ground at all. All you see is a colorful marker or metal plate. When firefighters need water from a dry barrel hydrant, they turn a valve that lets water up into the barrel and out of the hydrant, just like with wet barrel hydrants. But then any water in the hydrant after use is drained, so there is no freezing water and therefore no rupture. It might seem like dry barrel hydrants would be useful everywhere, but they have a couple of downsides. Since part of the valve is so far underground, they can be harder to repair than wet barrel hydrants, and the fact that they're basically empty when not in use can also be a problem because things can be shoved inside them. In cities, hydrants sometimes get clogged by people using them as makeshift trash cans, which is why they're not used everywhere. But in colder places, like here in Montana, that is a small price to pay for hydrants that don't catastrophically explode every winter. Exciting announcement! Here's the situation. The SciShow team and I were talking about a problem that we often have. People will ask us what we want for Christmas, and we don't know what to say because what is stuff for, anyway? It's so 20th century. But then I was thinking, you know, there are a few things that I would like to get or that I have bought for myself or that people have given me that I have loved because, you know, I love the world and the universe and the existence of life, that kind of thing. So, we put together a collection of artifacts of this universe. We got a limited number of each of those things and we have put them in a store called SciShow Finds. These SciShow Finds are curated by me, things that I know that I would love to get in my stocking. It's a very small list, just a few things with varying price points. We're probably gonna add new finds as we find them throughout the year, and those new ones will replace these old ones, so all these products are only around for a limited time. You're bound to have friends or family who would love Mars socks or trilobite fossils or the space shuttle lapel pin. And if not, you might want to get them for yourself or just slide a link into your mom's DM so she can get you some socks that she'll actually appreciate this time. And know that when you buy from SciShowFinds.com, you are also supporting SciShow, which you are doing right now just by watching. So thanks.